Good morning, good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I stand between you and your lunch. So my name is Manu Manahas. I work with the Philippine Center for Investigative Journalism, but also serve as the independent reporting mechanism researcher for the Philippines. So I thought what I could contribute is to give you an idea of the IRM process so that it completes the picture for you of the OGT, and you will see what to look for and how to assess your government, and you stay with the story. So the IRM, or Independent Reporting Mechanism, is a tool of the OGP to assess and discern the objective facts about the work by government and civil society from development to implementation of OGP country action plans. In short, it is your story, your OGP story. The report includes a long and rigorous method of research, public consultation, interview, and analysis with as wide a range as possible, meaning everyone important to the story of relevant, diverse voices, both those engaged and not engaged in the OGP process, brought into the conversation, meaning the fans and the critics. Okay? An independent assessment report, the IRM, serves as a complement to the participating government self-assessment report, meaning your government, if it's admitted into OGP, will submit a self-assessment report within 1 or 2 years of the country plan. Hopefully, this is in coordination or in consultation with the CSOs. At this end, the report seeks to look at the impact or the outcomes of country action reports vis-a-vis the OGP's grand challenges, and Paul has given us an idea of what these are. I just repeat them quickly. Improve public services, increase public integrity, more effectively manage public resources, create safer communities, and increase corporate accountability. Meaning, if we look at the OGP, we might ask, why open up? So what's the point of open government? These are the directions why governments have been encouraged to open up, and why countries have been encouraged to do their action plans. So you might ask next, how open up? Paul has given us some of the benchmarks for opening up, but I will just again quickly give you an idea of the process of opening up. There are 4 principles of the OGP, and these include transparency, meaning information is given in an open, comprehensive, timely, and freely available manner to the public. Builds open data standards, meaning raw data, machine readable, data open for sorting and analysis, not PDF and HTML preferably. Okay, so we have an idea of how it should be unfolding. Next, citizen participation. What is that principle? Governments must seek to mobilize citizens to engage public debate, provide input, and make contributions that lead to a more responsive, innovative, and effective governance. Meaning, notice should be given to you when activities are launched, including the information materials that will be discussed. Okay, so there are standards in the OGP process that will be measurable benchmarks for citizen participation. Accountability. There are rules, regulations, and mechanisms in place that call upon government actors to justify their actions, act upon criticisms or requirements made of them, and accept responsibility for failure to perform with respect to laws and commitments. And the others are technology and innovation. And there are, however, I think some of the story of the OGP, certain points for improvement that we all could help achieve. Paul has mentioned implementation is a key challenge. About 1/4 of OGP commitments have been completed, and that's very good by any standard if you look at OGP as a framework. The next big concern would be inclusiveness. Governments are encouraged to have everyone brought to the table to discuss country action plans, not just executive branch, but also parliament, but also the judiciary. So the inclusiveness also within or among agencies of government. Next concern, information should be meaningful. Meaning public consultation and public awareness efforts must actually be sustained and comprehensive and deep and broad, and this disseminated across wide communities and platforms, being not just print or television or radio, but also online and directly to the communities. Okay, now I'd like to also look at institutionalization of OGP. Beyond 2015, there is concern that many of the OGP governments will have new presidents or prime ministers, and there will be elections in this country, in my country in 2016, in Indonesia again, after so many years in Cambodia. So the concern is an awareness that OGP is actually beyond politics or political parties. An awareness of OGP is about people, about government, about countries. And finally, I think the issue of interconnectedness of the action plan ports. So a number of the CSOs of the Philippines, for example, we're looking at transparency being a very good value about our public documents on the budget online. But many countries are actually now looking at, in my countries in particular, the greater value of accountability. Budgets are plans. The greater truth is how money is spent. So, which means expenditure data. So to complete the story of the OGP, we want interconnected action commitments. Now, some governments have also been observed to be using the internet as a bypass for opening up. Meaning, if you're online, that doesn't mean you're open government already. If you're online, that doesn't mean you don't need FOI. Because FOI is rights-based, meaning universal, not just for journalists, certainly, as someone noted, but for citizens. Okay, so governments will actually also try to look at OGP as just, you know, open data, it's fancy, it's technology, but accessibility is a concern for many of our communities. In the Philippines, we have only about 33% connection to the internet. So many of our people still would not have access to data uploaded online. Okay? At this end, as a journalist, my questions are, what is the OGP story about? We will have to write that together. Not just our governments, not just our parliamentarians, and not just the CSOs here, but all of us in community with our citizens. So, it is the people who actually would have to feel what the OGP is about. Not in terms of concepts or plans, but in terms of reality. May I make an earnest appeal also? I think there are very few journalists in the community here present. May I ask you to also please include in the conversation journalists, independent media, citizen media, and netizens, because they can help tell the story of the OGP. We have missed out on bringing them in, and I think that is the story we have to write together. Thank you very much, and I hope I told you about the process. It's a very good continuity stage to the story of your OGP when you are admitted, when you have your action plan, and finally, when you are assessed. Thank you very much.